grandmothers, some mothers, they are very disturbing, right? They keep spanking the child, okay? So that starts building up no confidence in the mother, okay, as a child. And gradually as the child grows up, no confidence in woman, no confidence in woman. And that can lead to a crimes against woman also. So every action of yours
has a
consequence. Now the question is, what action can I have which will give the intended result with least possible damage? Now what is the positive or negative about it? Tell me.
Nothing.
It's clear? For that, awareness is important.
It's huge.
When you become...
The moment you have to be aware.
Right? Are you clear now?
Yes.
Okay. So now, first tell me, which role causes you more maximum problem in your life?
Daughter-in-law.
So, you have to...
Not today, but on the whole in my life, that was the...
Yeah, but now what? Currently?
Now, currently.
Currently, nothing causes me stress.
Okay. Every role, each role you tell one by one and offer, including your, not offer your mother-in-law.
Yes.
See, it has something leaves a has left a bad impression, no?
Yes.
Right? Or good impression, what else?
Lots of roles. All my roles are good.
Name it.
Yes,
name
okay.
It.
Yes,
you can. So you have to say, I play the role of mother, but I am not the mother. Okay? I play it well, but I am not the mother. All right? Many times tongues will not open that, I am not mother, will not, mouth will not.
That is a lot of things.
Mm.
So, okay, mother role. Then, play the role of a wife, I'm not the wife. So put that in. Play the role of a daughter-in-law, I'm not the daughter-in-law. I had played the role of a child, I'm not the child. I played the role of a friend, I'm not a friend.
I do a day, I do all the roles with the responsibility associated.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
mm-hmm.
But doesn't I don't
become. I'm
not become the roles don't possess me.
Yeah.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So roles possessing me is the problem of spirituality. That's called vasana.
Mm-hmm.
The entire spiritual journey is get rid of vasana.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Mm-hmm. So I've got a very heavy discipline.
Empty it in that positive.
Empty that.
I'm giving it off now. It's off me.
I have to write here.
Oh.
Your grandchildren?
I let go of my role as a child first.
Hmm. Role you don't let go.
Huh?
You play the role. Don't let go the role.
Okay.
If you let go the role, you'll become a monk.
Yeah.
See, so there's a difference. Here, householder path is play the role well, but be not becoming the role.
Okay.
If you let go the role, you will become a monk. You want to become a monk?
No.
Okay.
Why?
I am not the wife.
I am not the wife.
I am not the mother.
Right. go of all the roles.
Okay. When you let go of all the roles, you'll become a monk.
No, I
you let go
play of those roles.
No,
you play the role.
I'm not that.
You play the role, do it well, but I am not any role. Yeah. Right? I am the actor. So if you forget that, you get trapped.
Yes.
If you let go of the role, you'll become a monk.
Okay.
Understand? What is a monk? Monk is saying letting all the roles. That's all. Mm-hmm. Right? Nothing more.
So he has no family, no this thing.
No
so
role.
He just gives up all the roles.
No roles are played. So we can play all the roles, but not becoming the role. That's all.
Not becoming the worship.
Identifying the role, not doership. Role has a doership. Role has an action.
All those.
I play the role of a caretaker. I'm not the caretaker. I play the role of a sister. I'm not the sister. I play the role of a friend. I'm not a friend. I play the role of a teacher. I'm not the teacher. I play the role of a student. I'm not the student. I play the role of a shishya, I'm not a shishya. I play all my roles well, but I'm not the
role. I play all the roles and take care of all responsibilities.
I take care of all responsibilities.
Very well, but
I am not those.
I possess the role, but roles don't possess me.
I possess the roles, but the roles don't possess me. I let go of all the umpteen roles that I identified. But I will continue to play the roles without identification. Whatever role that comes from the...
I'll play roles and responsibilities.
Responsibility.
So none of you intend to become monks, no?
No, no.
So if you have to become monks, you have to give all the roles. Give up all the roles also. That's the difference between a householder and a monk. Okay, householder is plays the role but becomes possessed by the role, so then he is samsari. Mm. Householder who plays the role doesn't get possessed by the role, he becomes liberated. Okay, householder gives up the role, he becomes a monk. Take one by one role. Tell me one by one role. Ah, I know your roles. Which role you are very serious? I didn't tell you. Okay, even if you don't tell, I know.
Childhood, then my teenage.
Are you the mother?
Yeah, mother.
I am not the mother.
I am not the mother.
I have the role of a mother and responsibility of the mother.
I have to take care of my child, but I am not the mother.
I play the role of the mother. Well, very well.
Very well.
So this is not the idea of giving up something.
Okay.
Right? Mm-hmm. As long as you know it's a role, then the role becomes beautiful. Mm-hmm. Right? I am not a wife, but I play the role of a wife. Okay?
I play the role of daughter-in-law. I'm not daughter-in-law. I play the role of wife and not a wife. I play the role of student, shishya and not a shishya.
Wife, mother, your mother?
No.
Okay. So, play all the roles knowing very well I am not the role. Okay. That is the crux of spirituality. Okay. Entire spirituality, living spirituality means that much only. Nothing more. Alright? How to do it well, we'll see. Is it clear? We'll give a break. You can go to restroom and you can pick up a cup of coffee or tea. Continue. Okay, before that we'll close this. Okay. Now, this is a child, right?
Nice.
So, What is, you are also like this, once upon a time.
Innocent.
Innocent.
Pure.
Pure. and there's a glitter in the eyes of the child. So what happened to the light in your eyes? What happened to the light in your eyes and the joy in your face? What happened to that? Why you become dim?
Because of that.
Oh, Gayatri, you didn't give up. What are you finding? What is pending in your listening basket? Every time you keep something, everybody else does something. She keeps something and takes home. I don't know if it's from Rolls also.
You play the role of mother.
Very serious mother.
Yeah. But I'm not a mother. I play the role of wife, very serious wife. I'm not the wife. I play the role of friend. I'm not the friend. I play the role of student. I'm not the student.
Then what are you?
I'm the one who is watching the play.
Okay. So, what happened to the child and you? Between the child and you, what is the difference? What from that joy and peace to what you are today? Why? What happened to you people? What happened to you?
We're carrying this unwanted baggage, impressions, and all those. The child has absolutely free and liberated.
Because we think we are those roles, you know?
Yes.
So all that roles, responsibility, we think we are carrying.
That's it,
yeah.
Us.
Absolutely.
See, there is a saying in India, right? I'll tell you in Kannada, I don't know whether you understand. Makkalagadidre mukti illa. Have you heard of that?
Yeah.
Without children, there's no liberation.
Liberation.
In India is a country dedicated to enlightenment. So Kumbh Mela is there, right?
Mm-hmm.
Some 1.5 crore people join for liberation. There's nowhere on the earth people, so many people have interest in liberation. India is a country completely focused on liberation deep inside. They have a craving for liberation. And for sake of mukti, they keep on producing children. Right? So, actually, the saying earlier people said, Makkal agadidre mukti illa. Makkal hage agadidre mukti illa. Unless you become
like child.
Not by producing children.
Becoming a child.
Not becoming child.
Childlike.
So, what is the difference between you and childlike?
The expectations.
The child is in the moment, it's spontaneous.
Spontaneous.
And yes. Child is also playing its role as a child 100% without knowing or attaching.
There's no memory, there's no
yes.
past, there's no future.
Yes.
Your memory buffer is full. And you have become serious in life. And you know, children play this thing, they play very well. Okay, when they play, they play very fully, get involved. I've seen girl children cooking utensils.
Yes.
Rice is made.
Make belief, yes.
Yes.
So,
yes.
Yes.
Huh? Okay, there's nothing. They just say, okay, food. Then they go on horse riding. Real, as if they take on a broomstick and say, it's horse riding. Okay? The life is a play for children. For you become play has become very serious life. Why the play has become so serious?
Because the identification of the role.
So, the life is really a play. Okay. Now, that play you have made into very serious in your life. And when you make it serious, it leaves a memory, impression. And impressions are like public toilet. Smells. Okay. So I have summarized the entire teaching of all Upanishads and scriptures. This is the problem of life. Nothing else is the problem of life, okay? Your Upanishads and Vedanta, everything ultimately boiled down to this, they are trying to say in very way. So your life you have started taking very seriously. You have forgotten life is a play. That is called divine play. Okay. So why you have made your life so serious? Tell me. What makes you make life so serious?
Because of
expectations.
Why did the expectation come?
I have to achieve something.
Okay, you have to achieve something. Okay, now you let you read. Then what happens? You will be happy?
No. Yeah, somewhere. But some other thing will come after that.
So it's never ending, no?
One thing is, jnana wasn't there. My parents didn't teach, the whole thing is about the worldly life, material world. You have to study, you have to
be successful. Yes,
so nothing about the inner
society norms that we society follows. Because everybody is doing that, you also try and tend to fit in somehow.
We have programmed.
So,
true. Total programming. So unless we clear it, put a
fish in
then
you're
okay. Yeah. Conditioned to believe all this.
See, this is what is actually, we are condition, being conditioned moment to moment by the
exactly.
environment.
Society.
Okay. Spirituality is about total
deconditioning.
Clearing
the heart.
Okay. That's all the spiritual life. So now, why conditioning happens by the society? Everybody in the society, whether it's husband, wife or child, everybody is trying to manipulate the other for some result. Everybody wants some result from you. Yes or no?
Absolutely.
Huh? Yeah. So everybody has some
purpose.
So everybody is trying to program you in certain way. Right? And the husband comes from the office and brings a gift. Such a nice gift on your birthday. Along with the gift, so much of expectation also comes. When the wife gives a cup of coffee to the husband, it's not just smile and coffee. There is a lot of hidden clauses. Conditions apply. Right? Every interaction in life is conditioning process with conditions apply. Okay? Spirituality is about unconditioning and dropping all conditions. Unconditioned life. Is it possible? And how it's possible? Right? For that, you need a master or guru who himself is free from conditioning. Otherwise, you start getting into one more level of conditioning.
Different
kind of conditioning. That's called spiritual conditioning. So, if somebody has really become free from this conditioning, and such a person is called enlightened. Okay? So the enlightened person will not put you into more conditioning. He helps you to get out of your existing condition. That's the path. So the entire teaching of Upanishad is summary is that you are that. Okay, so the entire class is about this Tattvamasi, you are that. I'm trying to bring in various examples. Some different way I'm trying to communicate that essential teaching. Okay. So that realization, I speak in Kannada because I can only, that only came through, I mean it has came as a realization to me. Nanu, repeat it.
Nanu.
Nanembudu.
Nanembudu.
Nanalla.
Nanalla.
Ideha.
Ideha.
Mana.
Mana.
Buddhi.
Buddhi.
Nanalla.
Nanalla.
Sachidanandatma.
Shivanandani,
Shivoham,
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 Shivoham.
I'm not the body,
I'm not the mind,
I'm not the intellect,
I'm
pure consciousness,
I'm pure consciousness.
Shivaswarupi.
Shivaswarupi.
This is the only realization which you have to have in life. Everything else is accessories. This. So realizing this also means realizing God. God relation and self relation are not separate. Atmadarshanam.
Atmadarshanam.
Brahmadarshanam.
Brahmadarshanam.
Atmadarshanam.
Atmadarshanam.
Brahmadarshanam.
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 Satyadarshanam.
Satyadarshanam.
Atmadarshanam is to know the self. To know the self is Brahma Darshanam is to know God. Okay. To know the self is to know God. To know God is to know the truth. They are all synonymous. So one day I'll realize myself and I'll realize God, it won't work. They're all realization of self, realization of truth, and realization of God, they're all same. One and the same. Now realization of self is not knowing the self. It is actually getting rid of non-self. Getting rid of, or rather, concept of non-self associated with self. And it is only an intellectual process. It cannot be any other way. It's an intellect which is purified, can recognize non-self and become free. So there is something else beyond that. It's not, the self is not realized in a state of samadhi. It's not realized in a state of altered consciousness. Okay? So you may think that, oh, if somebody sits in a cave for meditation for 1000 years and he will realize something. No. It's a clarity which emerges out of an intellect which is purified through a logical reasoning. That intellect becomes purified. In that purified intellect, you recognize, oh, I am self. And these are all non-self. So that your question, your thing says, oh, it's only intellectual understanding. The intellectual understanding is the only understanding possible. There's no other understanding possible. The self doesn't read a recognition. Self is self-aware. Now what's happening is the clutter in the mind, which is clutter in the intellect, is overlapping on the self. That clutter we have to remove. And self. So, a self-realization is not a separate state. Self-realization is an ordinary state in a day-to-day interaction. You are the self. Now, that is getting mixed up with the body, mind, and non-self. And mixing up happening in the mind. So the mind has to be decluttered. Are you clear? Any questions? We'll break for a few minutes, then have a cup of coffee or tea, and then continue. It's okay?